So, you guys haven't seen the final episode of this season, have you? So, I'm not going to give away any spoilers. I think, so basically it was like the coma happened. So, before coma, she was mental because of what Ogre did. And then post-coma, she sort of remembers what happened with the Ogre, but she doesn't feel like it was kind of her doing it. She was a bit of a puppet, his puppet. So when now she feels a little bit like she remembers those things, she wasn't in control of herself when she was doing them, so she's got the guilt of it, and she remembers kind of crazy Barbara, but she is now cured to an extent, but still kind of on that roller coaster ride of ups and downs. So you might see her go mental again, but it will be a kind of considered, not as mental, but just sort of, she's completely in love with Jim still, and he's now turned her down. So she is still wanting to get back to him, but she's kind of angry now. So I think you're going to see that more of a kind of woman scorned type vibe off her, rather than just like, I'll do anything because I'm a dark creature that she was at the beginning of the second series. I personally read year one because that's the one that Barbara appears in quite a lot, but I know that a lot of the other casts, like I know that Robin and David especially dipped into the comics a lot, and Geoff Johns was really amazing in kind of supporting Robin in a lot of that stuff, because obviously their characters are so, they've just been, you know, played so many times in so many different wonderful ways, and there's so much information that they could gather from those comics that I know that they do probably the most research into the comics, and I know that they have some really special editions and all this lovely thing that like the DC world provides, which is just fabulous. So yeah, I knew from early on that she was very troubled, because there was a piece when I did the audition, there was a piece that I read that had been specially written for her character by Bruno that was never in Gotham. It was just like a separate, completely separate piece of text, and it had a lot of journeying in it through a lot of her kind of like alcoholism and drug taking, and it was a scene between her and Jim. And, you know, he was basically kind of coming home and finding her with some sort of prescription drugs or something along those lines, or talking about that kind of thing. So I knew that there was those kind of lights and shades to her, but there was never, right from the start, I didn't know it was like about the Ogre kind of moment. So that was, a brilliant twist that I really was so pleased that they did with her, and I think that it's led to like this really incredibly interesting kind of character now with such a huge range, which is what I'm so grateful that I've got to play. So yeah, I just love this journey that she's on, and I kind of hope that she keeps going in this dark way, because I think it's a really sort of fun thing to watch.
Story about the Ogre in Gotham and Barbara's love for Jim kind of reminds me of the Joker in The Killing Joke. Is there still a slight chance that Barbara might turn out to be the Joker? Or is that dream shattered?
That Barbara might turn out to be the Joker?
Yeah.
Well, someone told me yesterday she does in one of the comics, which was news to me. I pitched it when Bruno Heller, our creator, took me to dinner. He said, "Who do you want to be?" And I said, "Joker." And he said, "I don't know about that." So I don't know. I would love her to be Joker. I think she'd be a fabulous Joker. But I don't know whether fans would want that. I don't know. I would want that. We'll see. There we go. Thank you.
Yay!
I would. Single person. If you just write in, you tell a friend and they'll tell a friend.
Because we all know they're going to get back together.
Do we?
Well.
Yeah, okay, we do.
With the, like, do you reckon there's going to be the whole Barbara Jr. and Batgirl thing?
I think that it is something that they're considering. And it, it's probably in the pipeline. I don't know. They don't really tell me very much. But I think it would be a very interesting journey for them to go on, because obviously it's like, now that she's gone this much over into the dark side, how could Jim possibly make that leap, especially with Lee on the scene and what Lee's been through? It's going to be kind of a really interesting way of finding that journey. So I think that will be a really interesting story to tell. So I do hope that they tell it.